Matt Johnson, and I want to help you out with carving your first Greenland paddle. First suggestion I make is downloading a PDF document from the web called Making a West Greenland Paddle by Chuck Holst. Print it out, staple it together, and we're going to reference that through the build here. So anyway, let's get started. These are the tools I use for making paddles. A 3-foot flexible scale or ruler, power sander, a combination square, Sureform tool, small block plane, a jack plane, tape measure, C-clamp, safety glasses, jigsaw, and for finishing the paddle, tumble oil and a urethane. If you're going to get your material from the lumber yard, probably the best thing to do is take a look at the wider boards. The piece I found for my paddle is 2x12x8 feet, and the reason I chose that is because a lot of times you'll find much better 2x4 out of these 2x12s. Now, as you can see, there's some big knots in here. But I only need about 84 inches is going to be the length of my paddle. I only need 84 inches long by 3.5 wide. So I've got a nice clean piece out of that right there. I'll just cut away those knots, use that piece to drop for something else. Also, you usually find a better grain in these wider boards. If you notice on the 2x4 material, a lot of times you'll see actual circular grain, like the tree's only 5 inches in diameter and they cut the 2x4 out of it. So these wider boards are taken from, of course, bigger trees. So, like this one, the grain kind of curves up and it goes parallel to this edge out towards the end, and that's what we want. We want the grain nice and vertical. So, I'm going to cut that piece out of there. I'll cut my 2x4 out of there, and I'll have a really nice piece of wood to work with. I get my 2x4x8 cut out of that 2x12, and let's go on to getting some measurements for the pattern. I think it's easy enough just to grab the tape measure. We'll get an arm span here of 67. Now I'll go for the loom. Let's grab it like that. I like to just let the tape measure dangle, and then just kind of relax your arms, let them go to your side in a nice comfortable position, and then take a look at the outside, which is 19. So the overall length is going to be 84 inches, and my loom is going to be 19 inches. Okay. Paddle width, you can do the dimensions that Chuck Holst gives in his PDF. I know my paddle is around 3.25 to 3.5 inches wide, anywhere in there. And the loom, I also know I like about 1 1/8 by 1 1/2. So I'm going to stick with those measurements on this paddle. And the next step will be drawing some lines on this. And it would be a good time to go back to the Chuck Holst PDF and review the drawings he has in there. And then we'll start drawing some lines. Okay, so I got my paddle cut to length at 84. I want to mark the center of that at 42. I want to mark the ends of the loom. My loom was 19 inches. Half of that is 9.5. So to put my loom on the center, I've got to go 42 minus the 9.5, which puts me at 32.5. And 42 plus 9.5 will put me at 51.5. center of the paddle and the ends of the loom. Now, one thing I don't think was mentioned in the PDF is a combination square would come in really handy. Also, what we'll use for drawing the lines out is a 3-foot flexible scale. So, let's mark our lines for the loom, and we'll put a line in the center. And you do that on all four sides. So I'll let you guys do that. Get those lines. Let me give you a close up of what I did there. Lines there. And they taper all the way from the loom. Okay. Alright, now that you have the tapers drawn for the paddle blades, let's remove that from material. What I like to do is on the edge of the board here, and I'll C-clamp it. A little piece of board there so I don't damage my paddle material. Tighten her down. And as we're planing this material off, I cut this one already. I'll take my combination square and I'll run down it and make sure that this is nice and flat. Sometimes you'll get a crown in it, it'll be rounded off. So keep it nice and flat as you go, and it'll help you again make a nice paddle. Now you can, if you just have a small block plane like this, you can do it. You can remove this material, but you're gonna spend a little bit of time at it. I like to use a larger block plane, and it does help. And you can also, there are power planers out there. I have one of those I like to use also, and then I'll just rip the material off. If you have a bandsaw, of course, you can cut that off of your bandsaw, clean it up a little bit with a block plane. I'll start with the block plane and show you how this is done. You can tell, of course, there's more material to come off the end than there is here, so start with little strokes at the end here. And get closer to your line, your strokes will get longer until you're just right down. And one thing to keep in mind also is watch both sides. Watch your line over here and watch your line over there, so you don't start cutting crooked. You want this plane to be cut down right to the end of those lines all the way. That's going to take a little while, so work on that, and I'll get back with you. Now that you have your tapers cut on your blades, next thing to do is draw the lines for the outside shape and then cut that out. Let's start drawing our lines at the loom here.
I know my panel is about 3.5 inches wide, and to the center of that would be 1¾ inches. My loom width is going to be 1⅛ inches, and half of that is 9/16. So what I want to do is set my combination square 1¾ minus the 9/16, which is 1⅜ inches. So I'm going to set it at 1¾ inches. Make a line there. Make a line there. That should be 1⅛ inches, which is. And I'm going to go right down the line here. The other side. Let's mark the end of the taper for the loom, which in Chuck Holt's drawings he calls 1 to 2 inches. I like to go right in the middle and go 1½. So let's mark that from your loom edge here to there, 1½. Another 1½. 1½. Use our combination square. Let's draw a line right across the paddle. There. And there. Now this is basically the root of the blade. And the root of the blade should start at a width of about 1/4 of the overall width. And our overall width is 3.5, at least on mine it is. So we want to go 1/4 of that, 3.5 times 0.250 is 0.875. And that's per side. So we know the middle, we know the center is 1¾. So let's go 1.750 minus 0.875. Oh, of course, it's 875. So we want to set this at 875. And we'll put a little line there. And mark there, all the way around again. This is the blade root right here. And draw a taper from the edge of the blade root. There. All right. We're getting somewhere. let's draw the outside shape of the paddle blade. Now you want your taper to start from here. You want it to start at the blade root and stop about the distance of the width of the paddle. So again, we're at 3.5. Alright, so we want to come and make a mark. Let's use our combination square. Set this at 3.5. Now make a really light pencil mark on the ends here, because you're not going to take a lot of material off these tips. And if you push real hard on your pencil, you'll have a little indentation in there, and it might be hard to sand out. So kind of a light mark again. And we'll come across here, slide, very light. And now, take our scale, and we'll intersect with that mark we just made in the edge, and the blade root. And we'll mark all the blades, both blades. Now, last thing is we want to draw our tips, and I like to use a dinner plate. Oh, I just kind of eyeball that to where the radius of the plate is in the center. Although you could cut the shape out with a handsaw, I prefer a jigsaw. And again, we're going to clamp our workpiece down, making sure our cut lines are off the edge of our workbench so we don't cut into that. Safety glasses don't hurt. The trick to the saber saw jigsaw is stay off your line a little bit. Give yourself a little bit of room. After we make this cut, we can come back with the little block plane and clean up that and take the edge right down to the line. And always take a look at the bottom cut. Make sure these blades tend to bend. And if you push them hard, they'll bend more. And if you bend in this way, you can be cutting in too far on the other side. So keep an eye on that. And it takes a little while with the jigsaw, but you got to take your time and don't expect a perfectly straight line. We'll straighten that out in the next step. Well, the jigsaw gives us a pretty crooked line, at least for me it does. So after we cut that, let's take our block plane and clean up this edge, bring it down to our line. And again, I like to keep all my edges nice and square. Pretty good.
you can see, material is starting to rip a little bit. So I'm going against the grain in there. I'll turn the paddle around. It's a much smoother cut now. Don't worry about these corners yet. We're going to use the SureForm tool on that. So get as close as you can with this small block plate. This is a SureForm tool. It's not the best tool for getting in these the ends of the loom here, the little tapers, but it works okay. So probably the best way to get in there is with a draw knife or a spoke shave. But they're not easy to use either. Take a little bit of practice. And we'll fix that up a little bit with a sander later on also. I'm just gonna get it close right now. I'm going to go ahead and sand up the edges a little bit on my paddle using a palm sander with 60 grit paper. Next is step 4. We want to mark the lines on the edge of the paddle and on the face of the paddle. I've marked mine here so you get an idea. And after you get that done, we're going to move on to shaping the blades. It's actually the best part. Finally, we're on to shaping the blades. For this, you're going to need a block plane and a SureForm tool. And I'm going to show you how I do it. Our goal here is to cut a flat plane from this line on the face to this line on the edge. Should be a straight line between my two fingers. And I like to start on the tips. Using the block plane out on the tips here, it's really hard to start on an edge like that. You end up chipping the wood. So I like to use a SureForm tool out on the tips and bring those two lines in. Move on to the block plane. And if your wood starts to tear on you, most likely you're going against the grain, so you can switch your directions to get a smoother cut. And just work it down. Nice smooth strokes. You may want to adjust the depth of your cut. This area here, there's a little twist in the shape. So you have to maybe turn your block plane a little bit to get those lines come out.
Otherwise, I like the feel and the shape of mine.
next thing we're going to get into is finish sanding.
Well, it's time to finish sand your paddle. Keeping in mind, the shape of the root should be an oval, which transitions into a diamond shape with a little spine, which then transitions into an ellipse that continually thins down to the blade tip.
Use a tumwhile finish, but out here on the tips you need a little extra protection. This urethane will help with abrasion and keep the water out. So what I like to do is do the last couple inches of the tip here and let that dry overnight, and then come back and tumwhile finish the rest of the paddle with about 3 coats.
Well, this is my finished paddle. I sure hope you found this video helpful. And I'd like to thank Chuck Holst for providing such good instructions. And I'd also like to thank you for watching. Thanks.